Look, bud, go tell that guy in the hall to get going, or I'll punch him in the nose.
Oh, I wouldn't want to do that.
Well, send him in. I'll punch him in the nose myself. Send him in, will you?
Okay.
You can come in, mister.
Okay, Alan, you asked for it, so... Hey, wait a minute. You're not Fred Allen.
No, I'm Alan Ladd.
Alan Ladd? Well, Alan Ladd, the guy in pictures that's supposed to be so tough, huh?
What do you mean, supposed to be?
Go ahead, Jackson, punch him in the nose like you said you would.
No, he's shorter than I am, you know?
Don't let that stop you. I'll hit you so hard you'll be foolish to bounce back.
Oh, yeah? Now, wait a minute, tough guy. Who do you think you're talking to, huh? Who do you think you're talking to?
Jack Benny.
Gee, everybody knows me. Gosh, I'm so popular.
Yeah, just as I thought, Benny. You're a coward.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you've just been listening to $10,000 worth of talent.
Never mind, Mary. I'll handle him. You know, Alan, you think you're pretty quick on the trigger, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Hold on to your hats, kids. Here we go again.
Wait a minute, Phil. I want to settle this thing right now. Look here, Alan. Nobody sent for you. You butted in here and started this whole thing. What's the idea of calling me a coward?
Because you're yellow.
That's a liver condition. Anyway, what'd you come in here for? You play tough guys in the movies, and this is a comedy program.
Oh, yeah?
Now cut that out.
Jack, I'm only kidding. I happen to be in town, so I thought I'd drop over and say hello.
Oh, you were kidding. Now, well, that's different. I'm glad now I didn't hit you. You
listen to it?
No, not at all. Now, ladies and gentlemen, in our sketch tonight, I will once again play the part of that famous, fearless, crime-busting master detective, Captain O'Bennett. Phil, you'll be my assistant, Mr. O'Hara. And Mary?
Yes, sir.
You'll be the wife of the murdered man.
Is he dead yet?
Not yet, but he's at the Seven Seas getting a little stiff. Now, let's see. Who can be the murderer? Hey, I got an idea. Alan Ladd. Say, Alan, the murderer. I've got a great part for you. How about it?
Oh, nothing doing, Jack. I'm kind of tired. I just finished making a picture of Paramount called Solly O'Rourke, soon to be released at all the neighborhood theaters. Men in half uniform, half price.
Oh.
And you can best enjoy this picture by sitting in the balcony smoking a Lucky Strike cigarette.
Don.
Let him alone. He's talking about my picture.
Oh.
And you will rave about this picture while smoking a Lucky Strike, because Lucky Strike means fine tobacco.
Don.
So round, so firm, so fully packed.
Don.
Let him alone. He's talking about my picture.
Oh.
So free and easy on the draw.
Thank you, Don.
You're welcome, Alan.
Imagine coming here just to plug his picture. Now, let's get back to our sketch. And look, Alan, I'm still willing to give you the part of the murderer, if you can handle it.
What do you mean, if?
Well, the murderer in this sketch has got to be a pretty tough guy, and I don't know whether you're the right guy for it.
Hey, are you kidding? Let me tell you how tough I am. A couple of days ago, I walked up to Humphrey Bogart, grabbed me by the collar, and said, "Listen, Bogey, Hollywood ain't big enough for both of us, see?"
And what happened?
Well, here I am in Santa Barbara.
What's that you've got in your hand?
Bogart's tie hit me so fast I didn't have time to let go.
Well, don't worry about it. He must have other ties. Anyway, Alan, I'm sure you'll be all right for the part, and we'll do this sketch. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time on the air, we will present our blood-curdling drama, filled with mystery, murder, and suspense, entitled The Woman in the Window, or It's a Good Thing the Venetian Was Blind. Don't hush that one, brother. As our scene opens, I, Captain O'Benny, and my assistant, Officer O'Hara, are prowling around Santa Barbara in a police car. night, isn't it, O'Hare?
Sure is, Captain. There's not a soul on the street.
Yeah, but there have been complaints that the people of this town aren't obeying the new midnight curfew.
They're not.
No, they're acting just the same as they always did. Still going to bed at 9 o'clock. Say, you know, we ought to...
Calling all cars. There's been a murder. And here's the address where the murder was committed.
But before we give you the address, here is a message from our sponsor, the 15 Blackjack Company. Policemen, are your blackjacks getting sluggish? Do they sound dull when they land on a skull? They do? Then why not try our product? If you use the best bean blackjack, you're sure to get ahead. And now for the address.
The murder took place at 116 Serrano Avenue, which is right next to the Hacienda de la Caballera Don Juan Ranchero Amigo Cafe.
I know that place, Captain. Let's get going.
Okay. Hacienda de la Caballero Don Juan Ranchero Amigo Cafe. What does that mean?
That's Spanish. Forget the rum out of your Coca-Cola, fellas. Here comes the MP.
Oh, well, come on, let's go.
Okay, Mon Capitain.
This is the place, Captain.
All right, you stand guard here. I'll go inside. How do you do? I'm Captain O'Benny, and I'm here to investigate a murder.
Well, come on in, big boy. What took you so long?
Huh?
Baby, I'll shut the door and we'll be cozy.
Okay.
Be careful, Captain. It may be a trap.
If this is a trap, just call me Booby. Remley nearly killed that for me. Now, keep your eyes open for clues. And now, young lady, I've got some questions for you.
Good, Keithy. I've got some answers for you.
Oh, you have, eh? What's your name?
Just call me Cookie.
Never found anything like this in Grandma's cookie jar. Now, tell me what happened.
Well, my husband was murdered. Some low-down, dirty sneak climbed in the window and shot him in the back.
Now, wait a minute. How could a man reach such a high window?
I gave him a boost.
I knew he couldn't do it himself. I could solve this case if I could only find a man who came through the window.
You don't have to look any further, Carter. Up with your hands.
What?
You heard me. Stick up your hands.
Is this a robbery?
No, I just want to see if you use Jergens lotion.
How you do, eh? Well, put away that gun.
No, I have a lot of fun with this gun. Look, I'll show you. Now, you, Cookie. Come over here and give me a kiss.
Me?
You heard me, Cookie. Come over here and kiss me or I'll shoot.
Okay. Handsome.
Not bad, huh?
Bad? Why, your kisses are like champagne, like caviar, like filet mignon.
Champagne, caviar, filet mignon. If you think that's something, baby, I'll show you a real kiss. Here. Now, how was that?
One meatball.
So, well, listen, sister. I used to be the best. Hey, I got it now. You two are partners in this crime. You wanted your husband murdered to get the famous Van Dusen pearls. What's that you're wearing around your neck?
My shoes. My feet hurt.
Oh, yes, I forgot. Anyway, sister, I'm going to run you in.
Wait a minute, Blue Eyes. You talk to her like that, and I'll punch you right in the nose.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are listening to a transcription of an earlier broadcast.
What?
And it wasn't good the first time.
Cut that out. Now, come on, you two. I'm taking both of you to jail.
Oh, no, you're not.
Ha, ha, ha! You missed me twice. Go. Hey, Captain, I heard gunshots.
Yes, and here's the guy with the gun.
How do you like that? I ran in the wrong direction. Come on, Harris. We're going to drag this guy in.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, Captain. Don't lock me up. Don't lock me up, please. Give me another chance. I'll never do it again. I swear I won't. I'll go straight from now on. I tell you, I'm not really mad.
Are you not?
Don't hit me. Don't hit me. Put down that fiend blackjack.
What? Give me a break. Give me a break, Captain. I'll do anything you say. Anything. Anything.